What is the self? Who am I? There are two people within us. What I label the visible me, our physical body and brain, and the invisible me, our deeper core being, what I like to call our life source. The body and brain are ours, tangible, but they are not who we really are down deep. I prefer to view my mind and body as the tools and vehicle I use to function here on planet Earth. The invisible me, on the other hand, is what I would describe as intangible, gives life to the visible form, and is connected with everyone and everything. It is pure energy, what I like to call awareness. The visible me is not only comprised of the brain and body, but also the concept of self. The self, how we perceive ourselves, is a personal identity that many believe to be all that they are, and consists of memories and mental constructs gathered from past experiences to create an individual identification. These are beliefs that are held within the mind about who we think we are. It is our cerebral sense of being disconnected yet distinct from others. I am Charles. I am a person. I am a mother. I am a son. I am a teacher. I am a nerd. I am confident. I am pretty. I am a failure. I am successful, etc. are a few examples of labels that may form a mental image, a description of one's person. Yet, even though the descriptors may be factual, the self is not real. It's only a psychologically held perception, a collection of beliefs about our mind and body and our past life story, a concept of self, I suspect, to grasp our individuality. The invisible me, on the other hand, is not a concept of self. It is not a separate me, in fact. It is who we truly are beneath brain and body, awareness, being. And I think that our deepest being is also the source of our greatest wisdom. Unfortunately, this core essence of a person is often covered over, silenced, suppressed, hidden by one's obsessive focus on mental processes. Thinking, imagining, reasoning, believing, knowing, etc. The human race as a whole is infatuated, enamored, in fact, by its ability to reason. We are drawn in and caught up in perpetual thinking. So much so that when the visible me, the mind, the self, is left as sole ruler of a person, actually believed to be the entire person, it becomes dominant over our deepest core being. There is disconnection happening within. That person is only moderately functioning by way of brain, body, and the five senses, collecting information from the outside in. And awareness is almost completely turned off. We cannot experience the fullness of life until we learn to live life from the inside out, rather than from the outside in. We can learn to just be, alive through awareness, something beneath but also beyond our thoughts and mental processes. To better understand this lesson, try putting it into practice in your life. First, begin by creating space apart from thinking. To do this, practice pulling back from thoughts by taking a slow, deep breath, then focus on several slow inhales and exhales. With some practice, you will begin to see that when you stop thinking for a few moments, you are the awareness, a silent observer, apart from your thought stream. You are being. Be sure to subscribe to my channel and watch my other videos as I will continue to share more of my experiences and practices